On this episode of YaEat, we will be making New York Strip Steak Braciole with arugula and prosciutto. This is not your traditional braciole. We're going to pan fry the steak, we're going to make the sauce separate, and we're going to then place it on top. Hello everyone, and welcome to episode 45 of YaEat. As usual, I am really excited to have you here, and I appreciate all your support. I hope you're all having a great summer so far. I'm enjoying the warm weather. Today we're going to be making a really super delicious dish. It's a New York strip steak braciole. We're not going to cook the braciole inside the sauce. So we'll stuff the New York strip steak with some prosciutto, arugula, some cheese, and some other ingredients. We'll roll them up, we'll tie them up, we'll pan fry them, and then we're going to deglaze the pan, make a really nice sauce, and we'll use the sauce, and we'll place that on top. So I'm excited and ready to make this New York strip braciole. Are you ready? Here we go.
Print all our recipes on YaEat.tv.
Okay, so we're gonna first start off by cooking our garlic down in some oil that we'll use to make some sauce. And also to stuff the braciole with. We're just gonna smash it, just put a little pressure on it. Too big, and cut it in half. Let's add some extra virgin olive oil to our saute pan. Okay, so we're gonna start to cook this garlic in the extra virgin olive oil, and while we do that, we're gonna prep up our steak. So we're gonna remove a lot of this fat. Not all of it, but a lot.
Okay, we're going to portion the steak into three portions. You could easily get away with four portions.
We're going to just lightly brown the garlic. Or maybe a little more than lightly brown. So these are 10-ounce steaks, so these are 3-ounce portions after removing an ounce of fat, at least. Now we're going to pound these out. Now this steak is very tender as it is, and after I pound these out a little bit, it'll be really tender. So again, there's no reason, this is the reason why I use this cut of meat, because I don't want to stew it. I don't want to cook it in the sauce for a couple hours. We're going to give it a good pounding. We're going to pound it nice and thin. Unlike poultry, beef tends to hold together a little bit better, so you can pound it. This would also make a really awesome steak sandwich. Okay, we're gonna get started on the stuffing mixture, which is not a lot to it. Gonna add a little bit of seasoned breadcrumbs, extra virgin olive oil, chop up some of this garlic. In there, a little salt, pepper.
We'll give it a quick mix. We just want the breadcrumbs to absorb the oil.
We got our pre-washed arugula. We're going to chop this up.
Loosely chop the arugula and add it to the bowl. We'll add a pinch of salt, and we'll mix it together. We're going to add a little fresh parsley from the garden, and we'll add that to the bowl as well.
Okay, we chopped up our onion. I'm going to add that to the bowl. Give this a nice little mix together.
Lay out your pounded New York strip steak and add one slice of prosciutto to each one.
Slices of pecorino romano. The next step would be to take our mixture. Gonna add a little extra virgin olive oil in here now. No more salt. I'm gonna roll these up, right? Now, I'm gonna add a little more extra black pepper on top of this. Because my dad loaded these up with black pepper when he made them. With garlic, pecorino, and black pepper. Now all I have to do is now just roll them up. I'm gonna roll these all out, then I'm gonna clean my board, and then we're gonna tie them and put some toothpicks in them. Okay, now we're gonna show you how to just secure these. We're gonna put the stove back on. We're gonna pan fry these with the oil that we infused with the garlic. Okay, so method one would be just to, almost like putting like a pin. You just go in and through so it doesn't fall apart. Method two, I like to make almost like a little roast.
It doesn't have to be this detailed. You can just tie two strings.
Okay. This obviously takes a little bit longer, but a little bit more secure.
So we're gonna brown these steaks on both sides. They should cook fairly quickly because they're so thin. I'm gonna show you in a moment that the meat will be fully cooked when cutting it in half, but the cheese will barely be melted. You may need to add more extra virgin olive oil as you go. Okay, these are done. Let's remove them from the pan.
Next step is to deglaze the pan with the water. Oh, he used the whole bottle.
Help the deglazing process by lightly scraping the bottom of the pan.
We're gonna let that cook down for a little bit, about a minute or two, and then we're gonna add the tomato and some beef broth. So a little salt in here, oregano. Black pepper. Now you can pre-cook these and then just heat them up in the oven and then pour the sauce on top. Now we're gonna need to let this cook. The entire process of this sauce needs to cook for about 15 minutes. So we're gonna add some of the tomatoes.
I did wind up using the entire can of tomatoes.
I wrote beef broth.
I utilized the beef broth to keep the consistency of the sauce that I like.
We're gonna take the rest of the garlic that we have. We're gonna get a loose chop. Throw that back in there. Fresh basil on my garden. I kind of want this a little bit thicker. I don't want to add a roux, so I'm just going to blend these tomatoes a little bit. I'll let that reduce down. We're gonna see what one of these looks like. as is, not cooked all the way. Okay, this is reduced almost to the point where we want it. So I'm just gonna put this meat back in here for a couple seconds just to heat it back up. Remember, I've got three of these per steak, so I'm going to serve these as three. So the first thing I'm going to do is we remove the string for the toothpick. You don't want to leave that for your guest.
Okay, after removing the toothpick or the string, let's just put these in a plate, and we're just going to top it with the sauce and some chopped arugula. And that's it, we're done. New York Strip Steak Braciole with arugula and prosciutto. You eat, you want to eat, make this recipe, it's delicious.
Okay, that wraps up this recipe of our New York Strip Steak Braciole. I gotta tell you, I already gave it a taste and it's amazing, but I'm gonna eat some more. This is so delicious. Okay, so this is a really delicious recipe. I think one of my best yet. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this week's recipe of the New York Strip Steak Braciole, or Braciole Dave's Way. And we'll be back next week and every week with a new episode. We will see you next week and have a great week.
Here's an offer you shouldn't refuse. Subscribe to this channel.